Glad we got rid of that Windows issue. Now, if you're playing 14, you will notice that you can see there's a little bit of delay in the movement. And the reason for it is because your game movement is based off of your client, off of your computer. It's your client connection to the server. So it directly takes your keyboard and mouse inputs. Chugwa Racing, to make it fair for everyone else, instead runs server to client instead of client to server. So what you end up with is, if you hit the button to move left or right, there's a slight delay that it's not hard to adjust to. You just have to get used to it. See, because I got hit with those briars, we've run out of stamina already, so I'm not going to do so well in this race. Now, this is the track that has the green and gives you a little bit of stamina here at the end, but oh, I haven't seen those before. Again, second. Barely second. Oh, there's 5,000 from the challenge. 5,000 MGP from the challenge block. Another 429. Another rank up. Cunning, no. I want stamina. I want more stamina. Always more stamina. Now my Chugwa does have a fairly high top speed, which is how I get out ahead of everybody ahead of time, or over the course of time. So I read a couple guys on this months and months ago. Basically what they had suggested was that when you're getting to the point where you want to trade them, that the biggest things you want to worry about the most are a little bit of cunning, but then mostly endurance, top speed. Acceleration's okay. It's assumed that later on, because your Chocobo will gain abilities, and especially as you go up pedigrees, you can actually push abilities down through a line of chocobos. And so what you look for is you look for what some of these other guys have. Which is that instant boost right away. In that case, like, you don't really have to worry about the stamina anymore. You're going straight into top speed with an item. Might need endurance. And so pretty far ahead. We're just not going to push it yet. To 92%, so we should be good to push it here. Alright, first place. Only had about 5% left, but if it wasn't this map, we would have run out. And 535. Got a new rank that puts it at 35. I want level 2 endurance. You also don't have to look at your chocobo screen to see how many sessions you have available. When you go to pick it, it will, like, if you go to pick a feed, it'll tell you. That's more than our entry fee. That's actually our entry fee for the next three races, but looks like we're on Tranquil Pass again. Yeah, that's speed boost. Okay. Briar's killing me. That chest popped up as soon as I passed it. That's terrible. Oh well. Third. I've been coming last, that's the important part. No bonus for me. Got another rank though. Okay, we're gonna be in Costa del Sol on the beach. Yeah, today's just gonna be a chocobo racing for the next hour and 15 till Overwatch League starts. Tomorrow we'll be leveling the Bard again. But I figured today, since I've talked before about how there are other things to do in this game other than just leveling classes, it'd be fun to do something different. Nice. Okay. So we got a stamina tablet. Those red ones slow you down. They make you tired. The green ones speed you up and give you a little bit of stamina. The blue ones to speed you up. Getting that first item of a stamina tablet, which gives you a percentage of stamina. Usually it's like 8 or 10%, something like that. That's really nice. You can see that one slows you down. Okay, so we got Grab a Ball. Grab a Ball only affects something in front of you. So at the moment that's completely useless to us. Good news is I have more stamina than the guy. Well, I had more stamina than the guy ahead of me. Find me. But we're getting towards the end here, and there goes the way heavy. So we're gonna get first. Hopefully. We're gonna get first. We're well ahead. All right. $511 MVP. And rank 37. So in theory, three more ranks, and you should be able to retire. Retire the first Chocobo. I'm just gonna keep going with the same Chocobo today. Okay, that's our max speed up. Goalie Road Race. We're in the desert again. Desert's good. My Chocobo likes fair weather and heat waves, so. Oh, it's raining. Crud. So your Chocobos have a favored weather type. For example, I pointed it out earlier. Moonshadow here likes fair weather, heat waves. Why did I not have that? Bacchus water, like a gravel ball. Only works on the person ahead of you, which is exactly what I just got hit with. So basically, what the box water does is it sends your Chocobo into a frenzy. And in the frenzied state, they run at top speed, but they burn stamina faster. Which does this and runs you out of stamina later. Still got first. Barely got first. We still got first. That's gonna put us up to 74. I should probably up acceleration at least a little bit. Do that next time. So we're gonna be on Segolia Road again. So in theory, or at least from what I read, once you get your chocobos up to like 9 pedigree and really good stats, then there's a good chance that you can actually basically farm for MGP really easily. Pocket splatter is not one of those things you want to hold on to towards the end. Sprint shoes. No, I gave it to the other guy. I was trying to avoid that.
Oh well.
If I could have tagged them both with the Briar Wood or the Briar Caltrips, it would have taken the stamina on both of them. So while your chocobos are separate, as far as your race chocobo and your companion chocobo. They can wear the same barding. So your like if you go to your companion, this is your friendly chocobo or your grand company chocobo that can later accompany you. And you can pick their barding and you can feed them different fruits and berries and stuff to give them colors, like a color variation. Your racing chocobo can have the same or different gear. Like, you have all the same options that you would normally have. Color, however, is completely dependent on... We're doing acceleration. Color, however, is completely dependent on what you get lucky with as far as the covers when you buy them and breed the chocobos. I have that card. Costa del Sol, that's the beach again. Nice. So now, even with the MVP that I've spent on feed, it's still made out that I'm making more. Or I have more than I started out the day with. Heavy. So what heavy does is it instantly drops your speed, as if you're just starting out again. And then it decreases the amount of acceleration you can get for a certain amount of time, which lessens over time. So for the first couple seconds of like a grab a ball, it's really hard on your Chocobo. Oh no, he's out of stamina too! Yes! We're still like miles ahead of everybody else. So here we are in the middle. This is me and Wild Speed, the guy right behind me. And then the next one is like way back over on the almost the edge of the mini-map. Woohoo! Hi Thronezilla! Here we go, okay, so we hit rank 40, so now it's going to tell us about retirement and covering. Where'd it go? No, I wanted to act up. Retire. Gold saucer. Here we go. Retirement covering. This is what we're looking for. Oh, I didn't think that would close that. Okay, so your race chocobo has achieved rank 40. Rank 40 chocobos can be retired without handing over complete ownership to the Mandeville Gold Saucer. Once retired, a chocobo can be bred, resulting in a new chocobo for you to train and race. This process is called covering. The type of fledgling chocobo that is born as a result of covering is based solely on the pedigree and pedigree level of its parents. Pedigree level is determined by the strength of a chocobo's individual attributes such as acceleration and cunning. While the pedigree of both parents plays a role in determining the pedigree level of a new order fledgling, the blood of the lower level parent will often have more influence on the resulting offspring. Finally, if you do not have both male and female chocobo retired, you can hire a breeding chocobo for a covering process. Stock with higher pedigree levels will, of course, require more MGP to use. So basically what that's saying is, your chocobo is 40, you can now retire it. And you can either start a whole new chocobo, or you come over and talk to this lady, go to your race items, and go down to these covering permissions, and then just make sure you pick the opposite gender of whatever you have. And I'm sure that's what that quest is to retire my chocobo. We're not gonna do that though. Not today. Today, I want war acceleration. We're just gonna raise the chocobo up a little bit. I don't know what else is involved with the process of retiring and covering, so that might involve some travel and things like that, so we got about an hour left, so we're just gonna keep racing. So Moonshadow is a female, which means I need a covering of a male, which I already bought one that has decent stats. And it's purple, so I can't really complain about that. So we'll use that later. Hi, Maddie Pill. Did I? Yeah, okay. So we trained the chocobo. Race.